Greetings. If you are Muslim, I invite and encourage you to listen to this whole video. I invite you to understand the truth because Jehovah God loves you. I want to address the Deedat teaching where he tried to claim Allah is in the Bible, every Bible. Then we'll examine Deedat himself revealing the origin of this ridiculous argument. Spoiler alert, on the next slide I am going to tell you why Deedat made up this lie. I'm telling you in advance so you can watch and follow the proof as it is laid out. 3, 2, 1. Deedat tries to claim Alleluia is worship to Allah to stop Christians from shouting it. And I must warn up front, this is a bit longer than normal, but that is because this truth is critical. Allow me to quickly lay out the roadmap to come. 1. Hebrew Hallelujah and Greek Alleluia. 2. Deedat changes praise to angry shout. 3. Deedat changes God to no more than a punctuation mark. And 4. Deedat then admits why. 1. Hebrew Hallelujah and Greek Alleluia. Revelation 19:3. And again they said, Alleluia, and her smoke rose up forever and ever. That's the King James Version. This is Revelation, which you would think is Greek, right? Here's the Greek and the English. Hallelujah. And the Strong's number is 239. Let's also look at the last column, morphology. It has H-E-B, which stands for Hebrew. This actually derives directly from the Hebrew word. Here's from Strong's, number 239, Hallelujah. It has three forms, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, and Alleluia. And the usage is Hallelujah, praise the Lord. We see under the word studies a section that says, literally, praise Yahweh. Transliterated, Hallelujah. But notice this comment at the bottom. Alleluia, without the initial H, is actually a misspelling. Allow that to sink in. Alleluia is a misspelled copy of Hallelujah. This will be critical as we examine just how little Deedat knows of this word. Some translations attempt to correct this misspelling. In Revelation 19:1, the New American Standard saying Hallelujah, salvation, the King James Version saying Alleluia, and the interlinear says heaven saying Hallelujah. In Revelation 19:3, again, the New American Standard and the interlinear say Hallelujah, while the King James Version was Alleluia. Revelation 19:4, saying Amen, Hallelujah, that's the New American Standard, and the interlinear, again, Hallelujah, they are trying to correct a spelling error that was introduced. They're not changing the word, they're fixing the spelling. And in the fourth case, Revelation 19:6, New American Standard and interlinear and many others, those are the four places Alleluia appears. Revelation 19:1, 19:3, 19:4, and 19:6. Hallelujah arises from combining the Hebrew words Hallel, meaning praise, and Yah, the short form of God's name. Prophet David uses the name Yah many times in the Psalms, which Islam claims to respect. Psalm 115, 18. Yah, from this time forth and forevermore, praise Yah. You can also look at the Hebrew column and see that it says Yah, not Yahweh. Note in both cases, this is Hebrew word 3050. Psalm 150, verse 6. Let everything that has breath praise Yah, praise Yah, praise Yah, praise the Lord. Again, note the Strong's number is 3050. In Psalm 68, verse 4, Sing to God, sing praises to his name, extol him who rides on the clouds, by Yah, his name. Again, Hebrew word, 3050. It's important to see the next verse in English first in several translations. Psalm 146, verse 1, the New King James Version, praise the Lord, O my soul. In the Berean Study Translation, Hallelujah, praise the Lord, O my soul. And the Amplified Bible, praise the Lord, in parentheses, Hallelujah. Those are translator clarifications, right? So it says, praise the Lord, Hallelujah, praise the Lord, O my soul. In two of the three, the two phrases look like total repeats. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. But if we look at the original Hebrew, something jumps out. The first says, praise Yah. The second praises Yahweh, or Jehovah. Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, the Tetragrammaton. The base Hebrew words are not identical. In the first case, Yah is only Yod-Heh. Hallelujah is praise to Yah. In this compound word, Hallelujah, Yah is the name of God. We will later see Deedat's ignorance, claiming Yah is nothing but an exclamation point, a punctuation mark. He does that, and does it to the Alleluia form, so that only something that sounds like Allah remains to be considered. There are many more examples of Hallel to Yah in the Psalms. Psalm 135:1, praise Yah, praise the name of Jehovah, praise him, you servants of Yahweh. Psalm 94:7, yet they say, the Lord does not see, nor does the God of Jacob understand. Remember, Lord, in all caps, means Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, right? I've said that. Well, now I've learned here in this case, this is Psalm 94:7, and yet they say, not does see Yah. This is Strong's number 3050, not Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. So the short form Yah is the same as or carries the weight of Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, Jehovah. Psalm 111:1, Hallelujah, I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the council of the upright and in the assembly. Praise Yah. That's Strong's word 3050. I will praise Yahweh. That's Strong's word 3068. Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. Hallelujah is praise to Yah. Hallelujah, praise to Yah. I want that to be crystal clear. This is about as absolute a proof as can be offered. Hallelujah means praise to Yah. And now you know what Hallelujah means, and that Alleluia is just a misspelling of Hallelujah, missing the H. Let's move on to the second block of this topic. Deedat changes praise to God into an angry shout. Let's let Deedat speak for himself, watching his video and examining logical failures along the way.
Allah is his name, and this is the name of God Almighty, even in the Bible. Then I said, in the book of Revelation, the last book of the New Testament of the Bible.
Then I said, in the book of Revelation, the last book of the New Testament of the Bible.
John the disciple, he sees a vision. And in the vision, he hears the angels in heaven singing, Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
John the disciple, he sees a vision. And in the vision, he hears the angels in heaven singing, Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. Notice Deedat doesn't quite know what to do with his hands. He can't raise them up to God in praise, so he flaps them spastically.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
Revelation 19:1. After this, I heard a sound like the roar of a great multitude in heaven, shouting, Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and power belong to our God. That's the first case. For his judgments are true and just. He has judged the great prostitute who corrupted the earth with her immorality. He has avenged the blood of his servants that was poured out by her hand. And a second time they called out, Hallelujah! Her smoke arises forever and ever. That's two. And the 24 elders and the four living creatures fell down and worshipped God who sits on the throne, saying, Amen! Hallelujah! That's three. Then a voice came from the throne, saying, Praise our God, all you who serve him, and those who fear him, small and great alike. And I heard a sound like a roar of a great multitude, like the rushing of many waters, and like a mighty rumbling of thunder, crying out, Hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty, reigns. Now, as I was studying this, and I didn't want to make a big point of it, these are the four places Alleluia or Hallelujah are mentioned in Revelation. And in not one case does it talk about singing.
And in the vision he hears the angels in heaven singing, Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
In not one case does it talk about singing. Huh. I'm not sure. I don't know if I need to re-edit something. But the reality is, I mean, we shout praise to God as much as we sing praise to God. But it's not anger at God. It's not violent. It's passionate. It's full-throated.
I'm asking the Christians, have you heard that before? Yes.
I'm asking the Christians, have you heard that before? Yes. Well, as I mentioned, though, it doesn't say singing. I'm just still pondering why Deedat would try and change it to singing. Next, Deedat will try to equate Allahu Akbar with Alleluia.
When the Christian goes into ecstasy, like we say, Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
When the Christian goes into ecstasy, like we say, Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Notice the violent punching Deedat natively associates with Allahu Akbar.
It's Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Look at the angry expression on his face chanting the Islamic death chant.
It's Allahu Akbar!
This is what they scream as they murder in the name of their demon.
When the Christian goes into ecstasy, like this, Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! What does the Christian say? Alleluia! Alleluia!
What does the Christian say? Alleluia! Alleluia! Did you notice the motion of self-flagellation, self-whipping?
What does the Christian say? Alleluia! Alleluia!
Watch Deedat make a violent whipping motion as he mocks Alleluia.
Alleluia! Alleluia!
Allahu Akbar, violent punching.
It's Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Alleluia! Alleluia! Self-flagellation, self-whipping.
Alleluia! Alleluia!
Remember, John the disciple, he sees a vision, and in the vision he hears the angels of heaven singing, Alleluia, Alleluia. He hears the angels of heaven singing, Alleluia, Alleluia. And poof! Deedat has changed singing and worship to Jehovah God into an angry, violent shout with self-whipping. So now Deedat has changed the word from singing praise into an angry shout of violence, akin to Allahu Akbar. Keep this in mind, this schizophrenic, damningly deceptive argumentation of Dr. Deedat.
So right. I want to know what is Alleluia. Is it hippie hooray? Hippie hooray? Is that what it means? No. What is Alleluia? I'm asking, what is Alleluia?
So all right. I want to know what is Alleluia. Is it hip hip hooray? Hip hip hooray? Is that what it means? No. What is Alleluia? I'm asking, what is Alleluia? This is Deedat's simple straw man style of argument. Toss out an obviously silly or ridiculous position, then claim he's asked Christians. And they respond, no, what is Alleluia? I'm asking, what is Alleluia? If you're a Christian, you could answer Deedat right now, couldn't you? Alleluia is praise to Yah, praise to Jehovah.
So right. I want to know what is Alleluia. Is it hippie hooray? Hippie hooray? Is that what it means? No. What is Alleluia? I'm asking, what is Alleluia?
What is Alleluia? I'm asking, what is Alleluia? We all know Deedat is not actually asking anyone. This is a straw man argument, and a poor one at that. He claims to ask, to imply something. To imply he asked, and no Christian could answer. To imply no Christian knows. But now that you know, you could answer Deedat right now, couldn't you? And simple, trusting Muslims cannot tell this man is a liar who never asked anyone. He was just a clever man who tells stories to sell his errors and lies the way that Muhammad did. But you Christians now know how to answer his lies. And you Muslims watching, you could as well. Part 3, where Deedat changes God's name to no more than a punctuation mark. So this is the setup. The word Alleluia is used, and no Christian knows what it means. Deedat will next begin spinning his yarn, 1,000 miles from the truth, to implant his lie into the minds of the Ummah.
Alleluia! You see, the Arabs and the Jews, we begin with an exclamation.
Alleluia! You see, the Arabs and the Jews, we begin with an exclamation. We've looked at the Greek and the Hebrew, so we know the truth. Pay attention to the yarn about to be spun.
Alleluia! You see, the Arabs and the Jews, we begin with an exclamation. In our language, it's the genius of the language.
Alleluia! You see, the Arabs and the Jews, we begin with an exclamation. Know our languages, the genius of the language.
Alleluia! We start with Ya. That's the genius of Arabic and Hebrew.
Not only are we switching languages, but switching to languages that are genius. Now your pride in Arabic may blind you to logical failures in his argument.
Alleluia! We start with Ya. That's the genius of Arabic and Hebrew.
Alleluia! We start with Ya. That's the genius of Arabic and Hebrew.
I say, Ya Akhi, O my brother, Ya Ummi, O my mother, Ya Allah, O Allah. We start with Ya, you, the Westerner, ends with Ya, meaning exclamation mark.
I say, Ya Ahi, O my brother, Ya Ummi, O my mother, Ya Allah, O Allah. We start with Ya, you, the Westerner, ends with Ya, meaning exclamation mark. Except that's not really what the Hebrew does. See how this poor, ignorant slave of Satan has just changed the holy name of Jehovah God into a punctuation mark.
We start with Ya, you, the Westerner, ends with Ya, meaning exclamation mark. You say, Fa! Exclamation mark. Stop! You say, exclamation mark. Your thing ends, your exclamation is at the end, our starts with the beginning.
There's a fire! Exclamation mark. Stop! You say, exclamation mark! Satan's lie that Deedat received and spread changes the holy name of Jehovah God, Yah, into an exclamation mark. Your thing ends. Your exclamation is at the end. Ours starts with the beginning. But that is not even true. Hebrew, we have seen, creates the word hallelujah with Yah at the end, and it's not an exclamation.
So Alleluia is Ya Allalu, Ya Allalu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. I said that is what we are singing.
So Alleluia, he's singing. Ya Allalu, Ya Allalu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. I said that is what we are singing. So having diminished the name of God, Yah, Deedat focuses on the word praise, Hallelu, which sounds like Allahu.
Is Ya Allalu, Ya Allalu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu.
Ya Allalu, Ya Allalu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. Notice he again changes via sounds like replacement. Allalu is said twice with an L. Then he changes it to Allahu with an H. He changed the L to an H to change Hallel to Allah.
We are singing, the Muslim is singing. Oh Allah, you are the only being who deserves worship and praise. Oh Allah, you are the only being who deserves worship.
We are singing. The Muslims is singing. O Allah, you are the only being that deserves worship and praise. On to phase 3 of the deception, the psyop, or psychological warfare, to screw with the minds of Christians.
Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu.
Ya Allahu.
On the first, Eli, Allah, my Allah.
And this little ditty is how Eli Eli of Eli Eli Lama Sabachthani gets changed into Allah Allah Lama Tadektani.
This is his name, as it is there to be found today.
This is his name, as it is there to be found today. Nope. It is not the name of Allah. I know that, and I know that I know. It is not the name of Allah. I hope and pray you now know that as well. Part 4, wherein Deedat finally admits why he invented this fraud.
But people, the name gets stuck in the throat. The name gets stuck. They don't want to hear that word.
But people, the name gets stuck in the throat. That's the name of Allah. The name gets stuck. They don't want to hear the word. Yeah, because Allah is Satan.
So when I tell them, I says, you know, in my meetings, in my country, and other places in the Western world.
So when I tell them in my meetings, in my country, and other places in the Western world.
When sometimes the Christian comes along and he asks a question, and all the other Christians shout, Alleluia!
When sometimes the Christian comes along and he asks the questions, and all the other Christians shout, Alleluia!
They have done it. You see this? You have done it. Great.
They have done it. You see, they have done it. Great.
In other words, saying,
hip hip hooray. Notice he is still mocking, claiming Christians only mean hip hip hooray when they shout hallelujah.
So I start explaining. I said, you see, thank you very much for praising the name of the Lord.
Thank you very much for praising the name of the Lord.
And what you're saying is that, O Allah, you be praised. And I said, oh, thank you very much.
And what you are saying is, Ahu Allah, you be praised. And say, thank you very much.
Because this is how the word comes about. Ya Alleluia is Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. Thank you very much for reminding the people that praise the Lord, praise Allah.
Because this is how the word comes about. Ya Alleluia is Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. Thank you very much for reminding the people that praise the Lord, praise Allah. Drum roll, please.
No more Alleluias. Believe me, no more Alleluias.
No more. No more Alleluia. No more Alleluias.
You just explain to the guys that, look, this is what you're doing. Thank you very much. Thank him for it.
You just explain to the guys that, look, this is what you're doing. Thank you very much. Thank him for it.
And no more Alleluias. Finishes silent.
No more Alleluias. Finishes silent. So do you see the ploy, the plot, the scheme? It really accomplishes two things. The first goal is to silence Christians. The second goal is to blind Muslims. In the first case, when Christians ask a question in a Deedat meeting, possibly, even probably, one Deedat cannot handle and cannot answer, some Christians in the audience shout Hallelujah. Deedat wants to shut the Christians up, so he feeds them this lie that Hallelujah is praising the Allah of Mohammedism. And point two, even if Christians continue, a Muslim who hears it now imagines it is praise to Allah. Maybe even thinks, dumb Christians don't know they are praising Allah. But there is another rationale that proves this Deedat fraud is a lie. If Christians shouting Alleluia was really praising the Allah of Islam, every Muslim, including Deedat, would rejoice. Every Muslim would get frothy with excitement and shout Alleluia with them. I know Deedat is dead and almost certainly in hell, but his legacy of rubbish remains. Don't let his rubbish, his garbage, and his lies silence you, my Christian brother. Jehovah God receives the praise when you shout Hallelujah or Alleluia, while Satan and his minions are enraged when you do. But if you want to be absolutely clear in an auditorium, shout, Glory to Jesus! Glory to the Son of God! And if you are Muslim and you have watched this whole video, wouldn't you rather learn and believe the truth? The choice is yours. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah! Amen.